Good morning and welcome to St. John's on this Remembrance Sunday. We will stand to sing our first hymn, which is number 746, O God, our help in ages past, and we'll omit verse 2. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Please sit for a moment. Well, again, good morning and welcome to our service. I'm going to go through, actually highlight quite a few of the notices just to bring them to your attention. I'm off for a few days next week, so Kim Lafferty will be covering. Bob is going to take the Wednesday service and indeed the Sunday service when I'll actually be in Kirriemuir. So thanks to both to Kim and to Bob. The coffee morning, our Christmas coffee morning, which, how many years? 3 years since we've had our last one. So it's Saturday the 3rd of December in the morning in our halls. If you are available and could volunteer, then please speak to Faye. It would be good to have some people to help with stalls and with serving. But if you can, please speak to Faye. Our annual meeting is Sunday the 4th of December, and that will follow the morning service. We'll try and keep that going swiftly so we can get into the annual meeting. Please, I encourage you to come along. We need to be quorate, so please come to that meeting on the 4th of December, immediately after the service. The Golden Group Christmas lunch, everybody's had the information on that, but please, if you are coming to that, can you let Margaret know by the 27th, by 2 weeks' time, what you're wanting to eat for that meal. And another reminder about the Christmas card, St. John's Christmas card, names are being taken at the back. If you can give a donation, remember to put your name on the envelope so we know to put your name in the Christmas card, and that way we're reducing paper in terms of Christmas cards and sending a nice Christmas card to people that you would like to do so. And finally, a plug for the Eagle, for our magazine. Obviously, when Gordon and I leave at the end of this year, he has stepped in as a temporary editor. Well, we do need another editor. So Gordon will finish with the December and January issue. If there's any help needed for that, he's very happy to do so. We can still do things to help, but it would be good if we could get a volunteer for the Eagle. So those are all the things that I wanted to bring to your attention. We are here to worship Almighty God, whose purposes are good, whose power sustains the world he has made, who loves us, though we have failed in his service, who gave Jesus Christ for the life of the world, who by his Holy Spirit leads us in his way. As we give thanks for his great works, we remember those who have lived and died in his service and in the service of others. We pray for all who suffer through war and are in need. We ask for his help and blessing that we may do his will and that the whole world may acknowledge him as Lord and King. Amen. God is love and we are his children. There is no room for fear in love. We love because he loved us first. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith. God our Father, we confess to you and to our fellow members in the body of Christ that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry. Forgive us our sins and deliver us from the power of evil for the sake of your Son who died for us, Jesus Christ our Lord. God, who is both power and love, forgive you and free you from your sins. Heal and strengthen you by the Holy Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. If you're able, would you stand for our act of remembrance? Let us remember before God and commend to his sure keeping those who have died for their country in conflict, those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of humanity. They shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. Thank you. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today. Most merciful and ever-living God, we remember those whom you have gathered from the storm of war into the peace of your presence. Grant that we, being faithful to death, may receive with them the crown of life that never fades, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We sit for the readings.
Our first reading is from Job chapter 19, beginning at verse 21. Have pity on me, have pity on me, O you my friend, for the hand of God has touched me. Why do you, like God, pursue me, never satisfied with my flesh? Oh, that my words were written down, oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that with an iron pen and with lead, they were engraved on a rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. And after my skin has been just destroyed, then in my flesh I shall see God, whom I shall see on my side, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. My heart faints within me. Our second reading is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, beginning at verse 51. Listen, I will tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must put on imperishability, and this mortal body must put on immortality. When this perishable body puts on an imperishability, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. This is the word of the Lord.
Our gradual hymn is number 823, Who Would True Valor See?
Thank you.
the word of the Lord according to John. Glory to Christ our Saviour. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me I will never drive away. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. And this is the will of him who sent me, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given me, but raise it up on the last day. This is indeed the will of my Father, that all who see the Son and believe in him may have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. Give thanks, O Lord, for his glorious gospel. Praise to Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please sit.
This time last year, we didn't have a European war. But here we are, with a war in Ukraine, 31 years after they won independence from Moscow following the fall of the Soviet Union. Sacrifice in the service of others is called for yet again in a theater of war, one of over 25 conflicts going on across the world today. It is a sad total, a barbaric number. In amongst this, we search for the message of hope, that something good comes out of that sacrifice. Many parents, spouses or partners, brothers, sisters, they may rail against that notion that it is worth it. But we do call people to fight. Ukraine has called and pulled together a determined army who are willing to sacrifice their lives in defense of their country. They see something that they feel must endure: their country, their people, their values, their way of life, their self-determination. And of course, we worry whether they will regain all their territory, or, no doubt, a bigger worry for us, if they can hold back that Russian army and that they might go on to overthrow other countries. As we struggle yet again to get our heads round a just war, we send weapons that will kill and maim. There is nothing easy in this fact, but we want to protect others and our present and our future. Today is about the present and the future in our gospel reading. They will be raised up on the last day and then not cast out, but will see the sun and have eternal life. I will raise them up on the last day is not only something that happens later. We have the assurance that the experience of Christ in this life is not something that will be cast away at death, but will continue beyond death. We are talking about eternal life. We are talking about something that is worthwhile having, of being one with God. But the hopefulness of eternal life is challenged by our inhumanity towards each other, that the sacrifice that some of us had to and must make, that the change wreaked upon them, was and is devastating. For some, the pain, the trauma, the suffering, all too much, and damage remains. We know that the wounds of war can continue way beyond any peace deal or return from the front line. Those thus affected, their sacrifice continues. Our act of remembrance is important, but so is our action in what we do for those in need and our support of the peacemakers. Hope arises from suffering and despair. Hope arises out of the darkest aspects of our lives. The darkness may be at an individual level, that of our communities, or of society overall. Christ was crucified, but his resurrection and ascension are the resulting hope. This hope is symbolized by the cross. We are reminded of the human cruelty of torture on the cross, of the cruelty of war, of cruelty we still mete out to others through violence of different kinds, through our denial of the plight of others. But our response and our commemoration of other service for us fills us with hope on this day when we remember that sacrifice and work towards peace wherever we can. Amen. Let us pray. Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict and ask that God may give us peace. For the service men and women who have died in the violence of war, each one remembered by and known to God. May God give peace. God give peace. For all members of the armed forces who are in danger this day, remembering family, friends, and all who pray for their safe return. May God give peace. God give peace. For civilian women, men, and children whose lives are disfigured by war or terror, calling to mind in penitence the anger and hatreds of humanity. May God give us peace. God give us peace. For peacemakers and peacekeepers who seek to keep this world secure and free, may God give peace. God give peace. For all who bear the burden and privilege of leadership, political, military, and religious, asking for gifts of wisdom and resolve in the search for reconciliation and peace. May God give peace. God give peace. O God of truth and justice, we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world, and grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honor the past, may we put our faith in your future, for you are the source of life and hope, now and forever. Amen. If you're able, would you stand for the peace? We meet in Christ's name. Let us share his peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Peace, Neil. Our offertory hymn is number 635, For the Healing of the Nations.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Worship and praise belong to you, Father, in every place and at all times. You made us, all the people of the world, and everything that is. You gave us the daylight. Your word lights up our minds. Jesus was born among us to be light in our darkness. Your spirit lives in us so that we can look at the world with your eyes. One day we will be with you in heaven, but already we laugh with the saints and angels and sing their joyful song. Father, you never forget us or turn away from us, even when we fail you. You sent your Son Jesus, who gave his life for us. He healed those who were sick, cared for those who were poor, and cried with those who were sad. He forgave sinners and taught us to forgive. For all your love, we give you thanks in the way that Jesus showed us. On the night before he died, while he was having supper with his friends, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body. It is broken for you." After supper, he took the cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." So, as we do what he told us, we open our hearts to him. We remember how he died and rose again to live now in us. Together with him, we offer you these gifts. In them, we give you ourselves. Send your Holy Spirit on us and on this bread and this wine, that they may be the body and blood of Christ, and that sharing your life, we may travel in your company to our journey's end. With all your people, we give you thanks and praise through the Son and in the Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Amen. The living bread is broken for the life of the world. Lord, unite us in this sign. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away.
God's holy gifts for God's holy people. All are welcome to receive. If you would prefer a blessing, then please indicate at the altar. Let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace? We will. Will you seek to heal the wounds of war? We will. Will you work for a just future for all humanity? We will. Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that we have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all people and live lives of justice, courage, and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen. Would you please stand? And our final hymn is number 623, Eternal Father, Strong to Save, and we'll omit verse 3. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the King, the Commonwealth, and all people, unity, peace, and concord, and to us and all God's servants, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.